สวัสดีครับ Hello, once again, Kasit Piramya from Bangkok. This time I would like to say something about the situation next door, namely the Myanmar crisis as a result of the coup d'etat by the armed forces of Myanmar on the 1st of February of last year. It's now 13-14 months already, but the situation has not returned to normal because the military junta has not been able to complete the process of a coup d'etat. They have not been able to achieve the control of the country as a whole. But what they have seen more is more and more resistance by ordinary Myanmar or Burmese citizens of all walks of life, the students, the bureaucrats, civil servants, business people, academia, politicians at the local and the national level, and so on. And the resistance has come together, especially between the Burman ethnic majority and the various ethnic minorities in Myanmar, whether it's the Chin, the Karen, Kareni, the Wa, the Chan, the Mon, and so on. So there is some sort of unity and sense of purpose among the Myanmar citizens of all ethnic colors and so on. All of them have come together and decided they will have to push back the military into the barracks and restore democracy and the promotion and protection of human rights. But the situation at the moment is like a civil war in the making. There is widespread, fighting going on between the Myanmar junta, or the armored forces, and every type of people in Myanmar. The heavy fighting is concentrated in the northwestern part of Myanmar. That's the first point. And second, in the central part of Myanmar. This is very interesting because in the central part of Myanmar is between the armored, the soldiers who are Burmans, and the ethnic Burman majority who are resisting. So the Burman people are fighting among themselves. And then the third arena is along the Thai-Myanmar border. You know, Kanchanaburi, Prachuap Kirikan, Mae Hong Son, Tak, Chiang Rai, and so on. And it's the fighting mostly between the Myanmar armored forces against the armed ethnic minorities, whether it is the Karen, Karenis, Kayent, the Chan, and so on. So there's fighting going on. And some of the fighting is quite severe in the sense that heavy weapons are being used, like the artilleries and the bombardments by the armored forces aircraft, which I think were being purchased from the Russian Federation. So this, and there has been some report, and I think the gathering of the statistic that the fighting that has been going on and the severity of it for the past 12-13 months in Myanmar is much more severe and intense than the fighting in Libya, Syria, and Yemen combined. And the fighting in Myanmar at the moment is much more severe than what is going on in the European theater, namely the fighting between the Russian armies, military, and the Ukraine soldiers, and so on. So this is something that we cannot ignore. I think I have been observing that world attention has been directed to the Ukraine theater. And the world attention has somewhat neglected the situation, a much more graver situation in Myanmar. Because at the moment, out of 54 million citizens of Myanmar, 14 million of them are at the below the poverty line, without food, with water, the necessity of everyday life, and so on. They have nothing to eat, to say that they're in short. And among the 14 million people, about 1 million are the internal displacement. And a lot of these displaced persons are at the Thai-Myanmar border, majority of them at the Thai-Myanmar. and at the Myanmar-China border and the Myanmar-Indian border. The only country so far among the three that has been accepting the inflow of refugees is India. At the moment, there are 50,000 Myanmar refugees inside India. But for the past 12 months, 13 months, the Thai government has not yet opened its border to welcome the refugees and to look after them in coordination with many of the donor countries and the various UN agencies. So what we need at the moment is to pressure the Thai government to open the border for humanitarian assistance. And Thailand doesn't have to do it alone because money is available. Some of the development assistance money is being placed in the World Bank as well as the Asian Development Bank. So there is money. And if that were to be released for the humanitarian and development assistance, most of the products, medicines, vaccines, and so on would have to be procured from Thailand. So Thailand would benefit from the economic point of view as a major supplier of all the needs to be given to the Myanmar people at the border and behind border. So Thailand will play a very much of a key role, which it has been doing this for the past 60, 70 years and so on. You know, since the French Indochina War, the civil war in Cambodia, the Vietnamese occupation of Cambodia, and I think the civil war in Laos and so on. And I think they passed the fighting between the Burman army of Burma and the ethnic minorities along the Thai-Myanmar borders of the past 30, 40 years and so on. And there are still 9 camps holding about 150,000 Burmese refugees for the past 30 years. So Thailand has been a country with an open heart, with so much of humanitarian concern for the fellow humanity. But it is a surprising and it is quite unbecoming, and it is something not rational at all that the present Thai government, under the leadership of General Prayut Chan-o-cha, has been, I think, mute and blind to the situation in Myanmar. And there is no green light from the Thai government to open the border. So what we need to do is to, I think, join force in pressuring the Thai government to open borders for humanitarian assistance. Humanitarian corridors can be set up, and there could be coordination between the Thai government and the United Nations under the auspices of the UN Secretary General. And then at the same time, there could be also more coordination from the various donor countries and international civil society organization or international NGOs. Everything is more or less in place in the sense that money is available, the goods are available, the personnel at the community level or within the context of the NGO are already. But what is needed now is the political decision of the Thai government under General Prayut Chan-o-cha to open the border and to be take the lead in the coordination of the humanitarian assistance. As a Buddhist country, or as a country with at least 3 major religions, Buddhism, Islam, and Christianity, it could not be helped but for Thailand to render that kindness to fellow human beings that are dying every day, not only of the fighting, but of starvation and of sickness, of disease, and so on. And it is also in the interest of Thailand not only to be able to supply the goods and so on, but Thailand has to move fast because besides COVID-19, I think the return of malaria to the area is becoming a sort of a worry. So Thailand needs to open the border so that vaccination and I think a campaign against malaria as well as COVID-19 could take place in a more constructive and I think effective manner. So these are a few points that I would like to leave with you, you know, to press your respective governments to work together, to press the Thai government to act accordingly for humanity, for our fellow Myanmar friends, citizens of the ASEAN community. Thank you very much. ขอบคุณมากครับ